What is popping, people? It's your boy Mikey JTV in the motherfucking place to be. Today, we are going to be talking about infinite healing. Now, when I say infinite, I don't really mean it in the literal sense, but it's going to be enough healing for you to basically just switch the character, do the healing thing and all that. Okay, so obviously there's going to be some stuff that you're going to need beforehand because I just... Look at Qiqi. She's just adorable. Look at her. Oh my goodness. But anyway, you're gonna need a specific set of stuff, and you're gonna need a couple artifacts to make it just a little bit easier. But let's go ahead and switch to the weapons real quick. All right, so we've got the sacrificial sword, and this type of set, it can go for literally anybody. We're just using Qiqi just for an example. But I also have sacrificial fragments on sucrose. So basically what this weapon set does is it gives you a 40% chance to kill the cooldown on any skill. So with what Qiqi does, if we look at her first talent, if we look at her second talent, which is the Adeptus Art Herald of Frost, whenever she strikes a opponent, it regenerates HP for all the party members. That's kind of busted. So look, if you pair that with the weapon she has, sacrificial sword, and apparently this one has energy recharge. I really want to ascend this one more time so we can get more energy recharge. So the mix between energy recharge, the cooldown canceling, all of that will give you a substantial amount of healing very, very quick. Okay, so quick thing, I didn't happen to record this while I was playing, but I'm gonna go ahead and go over her artifacts. Artifacts do make a big difference in how this works. Not too big, but big enough that I should actually mention. So if we look at our artifacts, we do have, I think, one or two. Yeah, see, this one has a sub of energy recharge. You definitely want to have those energy recharge. I do have her on Berserker, and I have her on Berserk, but I do believe that, like, the Berserk isn't... I don't know why I have her on Berserk. Oh, I know why I have her on Berserk, because her healing scales with her attack. So that's something Qiqi specific. Qiqi specific, I think that's how you say that. I'm not sure, man. The Chinese language is very, very interesting, the way that they say things and do things. So if you look at how I have her set up, there is a very common theme about the feather. It's got attack percent, attack percent, attack percent, attack percent. So that's how I set her up. Now, if you just happen to get attack percent with energy recharge, like I do have on this instructor's helmet, you'll be good to go. Energy recharge and attack is what Qiqi needs. Now, depending on who you use, I mean, you can use, let me see. Say, for instance, you get the free Barbara at level 20, right? Her weapon, if you pull the sacrificial fragments, if you pull that, you can put that on Barbara and just have her on energy recharge. Energy recharge, that's all you need. Energy recharge and health for Barbara, and then she could be an infinite healer. So it doesn't matter which unit you have, it really is just about the cooldowns. It's about the cooldowns. So yeah, but the scaling with attack thing, that's a Qiqi, you know, that's a specific thing. But just for this video's sake, I will say, you know, you could use it on anybody. Just the three main things are having a high recharge rate and the actual weapon, and you're good. We're gonna take on one of these cube bosses today. I think this is the wind one that we're headed towards. Faster. Okay, faster. All right, so we're gonna see exactly how this setup is going to work. So let's go to official, because she doesn't have a lot of health, and we're going to just see how this is going to work out. I am adventure rank 25 right now. Oh, that's didn't think he was going to need to use this quick. You see how I just used that? Now look at my cooldown. It's already back. It's already back. So I can use this again while I'm still healing, while the little ice thing's out. It's absolutely insane. Gonna run it again. Will it work again? That skill does have a 30-second cooldown. It does have a 30-second cooldown. Nope. It does have a 30-second cooldown, so you can only use it 30 seconds apart. But even still, like, look at Fischl's health. It's back to normal. Wait, why am I doing that? I should be hitting this. And I missed it. Okay, anyway. So we're back, and we do it one more time. So we got the thing. If I were to use Venti, it would be very great here. And we do that, and we heal, and look at it. It's already back. It's kind of crazy. It's kind of crazy. All right. So we should probably use the official Zhang Lang tech to take this bad boy on out. We stop that. Oh, crap. All right. More healing. And it's back again. It's just so good. There's no reason for this to not be so good. It's kind of crazy. Qiqi's not the fastest character, I tell you that. All right, boom, boom. All right, boom. And give me that. Yes, sir. And like I say, Sucrose actually has the same type of weapon set, and it does the same thing, but Sucrose is pretty much a DPS unit, honestly. Oh, crap. Don't do that again. Because she needs to live. All right, let's go. And it's back again. Freeze. Ah, dang it. One, two, there we go. And that should actually give me a cooldown soon. Because she's got the sacrificial book. Ow. Hello. So you guys can see where I'm going with this. So at any moment's notice, you can just wait. Boom, 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 boom. And it's back again. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. Look at the healing on the right side. It's just great. It's just great. Can you do the thing? Boom, boom, boom. Oh, didn't get it. Oh, give me that before you suck it in. There we go. Boom. All right. I just need you to get exposed. And it should call it a wrap. There we go. And that's a wrap. That's one big crystal fly. I guess we can just use that. All right, confirm. And there we go. We got a lot of good stuff off of that. I really don't know as of right now what to do with the hurricane crystal seeds, but you know what, the hurricane seed. But yeah, that's pretty much how that works. I was a little greedy at the end using Fischl. I should have switched into Qiqi to do her infinite healing thing, but you know, it's cool. It's cool. That weapon is so good. It's just good. I don't know what to tell you. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for the next, stay tuned for the next Genshin Impact video, and I will see you guys later. Peace.